I think, though, what's happening in Israel, if I can say, I'm retired, so now I can say. What is demonstrably at play is, if you look at the history of what's been happening for the last 20 or 30 years, all over the world, but especially in Israel intensely lately, a resistance to this ever-increasing expansion of the protection of rights. So when you have protection of rights and it works well, it includes the rights of those whom you don't like. The ultra-Orthodox will be protected by a Supreme Court. But when they decide they want to change, when the very conservative elements want to change the way the system functions, to eviscerate the capacity of a court to review legislation that creates rights for others and keeps it only for them, then I think you are not dealing with democratic institutions. You are dealing with people who want to keep a status quo which goes against Israel's values. Why do I say that? Because if you look at the Declaration of Independence for Israel, if you look at why the state was set up, if you look at what it was meant to address, namely populism run amok in Germany, which affected a minority, the Jewish people. And that's what Israel was designed to do, to make sure that never happened again. And the court was the bulwark against this. Now what's happening is a process that was not put to the population before the election to consider, and has the effect of taking away the power of judicial review, meaningful judicial review, so that there is no space between a government decision and anyone to check it. And the result is government can do anything it wants. That is not a liberal democracy, and that is not what Israel was set up to do.